Hello, my name is Cassie and welcome to the New York Transit Museum. We are right now in the oldest subway train that we have at the New York Transit Museum. It was built in 1916 by a company called the BRT. That's Brooklyn Rapid Transit Company. We are going to start looking at all of the features of this train. And when we do this, we're going to think about how things are different now than they were back when the trains first started running. First thing I want to look at are these poles that I'm standing near. You see, these poles are white, as you see. They are not silver, like the ones that you would be using today. And they are painted with porcelain paint. Now, do you know any places that you might have seen porcelain before? Now, I know that I see porcelain in the bathroom a lot, in sinks and in bathtubs. And that's because it's a good material to be able to clean easily. Now, you might also have noticed that there are lots of poles here. There's four poles right here, and there's more poles throughout the train car, and they make these weird shapes on the ground. These poles form a diamond on the floor. Now, this takes up a lot of space. The idea of these poles was that you would stand on the inside when you were holding onto the pole so that people could go in the indoor and out the outdoor right there. I don't know if you have ever ridden the subway today, but do you think that New Yorkers would follow those rules? No, they didn't. That is something that they were trying that did not work. Now, all of these things that they were trying, we could think of as innovations. An innovation is something that we change over time to try to make it better. So we thought that maybe it was the best idea to have poles so that people would stand on the inside, but that is an innovation that did not work. One other thing I want to show on this train car are these seats. So I'm going to feel the seat right here. It feels bumpy and it feels woven. It is made out of a material called rattan. Rattan is a plant that is very similar to bamboo. And you would take the rattan and weave it together and make these seats. Now, these seats are quite bouncy, and they are quite comfortable. I'm gonna sit on one. So, sitting on this bench, I notice, like I said, they are bouncy. They're more squishy than the seats that we sit on today, but there are some problems with these seats. Wonder if you can think of any. One problem that I see with these seats is that if I was to spill something on this seat, do you think that it would be easy to clean? I don't think so. If you spilled something on this seat, it would soak right into the cushion, and that would make it so that the seat would be filled with whatever you spilled on it. Now, if that was water, that'd be okay. But imagine if you spilled juice or milk on that seat. Wouldn't be so good. It would start stinking, it would be sticky. That's not great. Something else that happens with these seats is that they can break really easily. And when they start to break, they fall apart and the little pieces stick out and they can poke you in the leg. And that's not really fun. If you were wearing tights at that time, which a lot of ladies did, you would get a run in your tights and it wouldn't be very comfortable. And then you would get a bigger and bigger hole, and then you would have to replace the whole seat. And that's really expensive. I wonder if there's a way that we could innovate these seats to make them better for the subway system. I think what we should do is we should look at a new train, a train that is running in New York City today, to see how we've changed these things, to try to innovate them to make them better. Let's go. All right, so here we are at the R44 train car. This train car ran in the New York City subway system until 2010, but it still runs in Staten Island today, and it looks a lot like the trains that still run in our system right now. So it's a good one to think about for what we have going on right now in the New York City subway system. So let's go back to the seats. And I'm gonna feel this seat. It is smooth. It is hard, not bouncy at all. Now, this seat is made out of a material called plastic. I bet that you know a lot of things that are made out of plastic in your daily lives. It's sturdy, and it doesn't break very easily. And also, if I spilled something on it, I could clean it really easily. That makes it a much better material for a subway system that runs 24 hours a day. Now, let's take a look at these poles. There's a lot of poles on this train car, but let's just look at this one. It is shiny and silver, made out of a material called stainless steel. Now, stainless steel is very easy to clean, and it doesn't chip like porcelain paint might. It also never rusts. So this material is really good for the subway. We can hold on to it and clean it really easily so that we can keep everybody safe from germs. There's also a lot of poles on this subway car, but they are not clustered together. They're all spread apart. That's because we want to make sure that everybody has a space to hold on throughout the whole train car. We don't have any poles that are so close together like we did on the last one, because we don't want people all standing smooshed together in one spot. We want them all across. That's an innovation that we've changed over time. Now, I wonder what kinds of train cars we'll see in the future. Sometimes people think about adding Wi-Fi to train cars. Sometimes people think about adding a snack car to a train car or having trains that fly. These are all things that might happen, I don't know. I wonder what kind of innovations we'll see in 20 years, 30 years. Can you think of any innovations that you would like to see on the subway system? Thank you for exploring with me, and I hope to see you again soon.